So do you and your family have any Purdue traditions that you participated in?
Well, I think probably one Purdue tradition that we participate in is, of course, here you get a little bit more snow than the average place. And when you do, you know, our first time at Slater Hill was a lot of fun, sleighing down the hill. And the crowd was great. You know, the enthusiasm of, you know, sledding down a big hill and never knowing where you're going to end. And the traffic that you get because it's a ton of students and people over there was a lot of fun. So we like to do that. When the weather starts to get snow on the ground, and that's always enjoyable for the family.
Yeah, that's fun. And I know we've touched on it throughout this interview, but any other thoughts around this community, you know, raising your kids here, your family? This is like an all-in-the-family thing for you guys.
Well, we really have tried to be a big part of the Purdue community, and that's, you know, like I said, we live right across the street of campus, so we're able to come over here whenever we want. We bought a golf cart a couple years ago just to be able to come over here and drive around and see everything and tour the campus, and my son likes to, any visitors we have here, give them a tour of campus and use the golf cart, which I hope is legal, to do that, and that's been a whole lot of fun. It's just kind of, you know, from the Catholic Church of St. Thomas Aquinas over there, which we attend, and all the beautiful buildings, the engineering building, the business building, you know, the president's office, you know, going to Mackey and the baseball and softball fields and soccer fields, tennis center. We've kind of tried to do all of it, you know, the beautiful golf courses. Really, it's just a nice big campus with a lot of academically driven individuals that want to get a degree and move forward in life and have success, and you know, being able to throw football in there has been fun. And it's a safe place to live with a lot of really special blue collar people, and that's kind of what we're about. Is we don't need any extra pizzazz or you know, ribbon on top of anything. You know, I still have my Honda Accord and have to hear about that, and you know, but that's always fun to just be a normal person and enjoy life.
When you say you're a normal person, do people come up to you on campus and talk to you? Is Brady kind of the gatekeeper there?
You know what, probably not as much as you think. I think everybody relates well with everyone, and you know, you can go around the community and run into some people that want to talk, but for the most part, it's been great, and you know, we enjoy getting out and doing a lot of different activities.
I think Brady needs a paycheck from Purdue.
Don't bring that up.
He would like that. Trust me, he's taken care of very well right now.
Do you see him wanting to go to Purdue in the future?
Well, that probably is a go of his. I told him you need to get those grades up if you want to go to Purdue. This isn't just an easy place to get
right in.
So he's got a little work to do there. But he loves the people here, and he you know, spends as much time in this building as I do, which is a lot, and really just is a people person. So I'm hopeful that, you know, he'll figure out the exact path that he wants, and without question, Purdue can help get him there.
Is there anything else you want to tell our listeners?
Oh, you know, you got it all. You did a good job.
Thank you so much. Yep.